We're in the newsroom. In other news, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. is meeting with Malaysia's King and Prime Minister, one of the highlights of his state visit to the country. Let's get more details on that from our very own Pia Gutierrez, who is in Kuala Lumpur. She joins us now live. Pia, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, it's day two of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s three-day state visit here in Kuala Lumpur. And today, he's set to hold high-level meetings with leaders of Malaysia. Malaysian King Al Sultan Abdullah and Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim welcomed the president and the Philippine delegation in a state ceremony held at the Istana Negara, or the National Palace, here in Malaysia. This was followed by his meeting with King Al Sultan Abdullah, who is also hosting a state banquet in honor of the president at the palace at noon. In a speech before the Filipino community yesterday, Marcos Jr. described the king as a longtime family friend. And during this meeting, both leaders are set to discuss how both countries can further deepen partnerships through new areas of mutual interest. Later at 3 in the afternoon, Marcos Jr. will also hold a bilateral meeting with Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim in the afternoon to pursue areas of cooperation in agreed priority areas that are aligned with the respective economic agenda of both countries. Ibrahim earlier visited the Philippines last March 2023, and according to the Department of Foreign Affairs, the reciprocal visit between the leaders of both countries is a testament to the reintegrated relationship between the Philippines and Malaysia. This is both countries mark the 60th anniversary of the establishment of their diplomatic ties. Prior to this, the president yesterday met with members of the Filipino community here in Kuala Lumpur, and in his speech, he assured the OFWs that the Philippine government is working to ensure their well-being as they pursue strengthened ties with Malaysia.
Isa na ito na ating pag-iikot upang siyempre kailangan natin patibayin ang relasyon ng Pilipinas at saka ng Malaysia. Unang-una dahil napakaraming Pilipino rito. At kaya kailangan natin tiyakin na lahat kayo ay naaalagaan at lahat kayo ay maayos ang kabuhayan at nabibigyan ng mga pagkakataon kung bakit kayo lumipat at umalis sa Pilipinas ay para nga dito sa mga opportunities na nakikita ninyo rito. Ngunit kailangan namin tiyakin na yung mga opportunity na yan ay nandiyan pa rin. At habang kayo nagtatrabaho dito, hindi naman kayo nahihirapan.
Carmina, we have yet to talk to President Marcos Jr. during this trip, but in a tweet he posted this morning, he assured that even while he is here in Kuala Lumpur, government resources are being deployed to ensure that the effects of the super typhoon Egay is being responded to. He said that at least 173 million in standby funds, as well as food and non-food items, are already available for deployment. This also includes search, rescue, and retrieval personnel from the Armed Forces of the Philippines, the Bureau of Fire Protection, and the Coast Guard. He says that government authorities are ensuring that the over 38,991 families affected in regions 1, 2, 3, Calabarzon, Mimaropa, region 6, 7, and 8 or 12, their needs are being attended to. The president is set to return to the Philippines tomorrow afternoon, but before that, he's scheduled to meet with Malaysian leaders to entice them to invest in the Philippines. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Pia Gutierrez there joining us live from Malaysia.